I have a really exciting AI tool for you today. It's called Tempo Labs. It's an AI coding tool that covers the whole process from requirements to design all the way to production ready code. I'll break it all down for you and I'll show you what I discovered using this tool. Hi, my name is Jad. As usual, I'm covering another great AI tool today for building products. It's a very new tool called Tempo Labs, and the team reached out to me to review their tool. I get a lot of emails like this, but I decided to review this one because it looks very promising to me, and it has the potential to change how teams work on building products, specifically the interaction between designers and developers. So yeah, it's still an early release, but it looks very promising. And I will show you exactly how to use it as a designer, even if you don't know anything about coding. As a UI UX designer, this tool gave me enough features that I'm considering implementing it in my workflow, but it needs a little refining first. So Tempo is specialized in creating React apps. And what I love about it is that I can hand off a functional production ready design to a developer rather than a prototype with tons of documentation. It's structured in a way that allows teams to work together. And that's why it packs a lot of features. So it might look intimidating at first, but don't worry, I'll break everything down for you. So here's my project folder. Let's create a new project, and you have the option here to import an existing project from GitHub or to start designing on a blank canvas. But for the purpose of this video, we want to see the power of AI here. Let's generate something with AI. So to start with a simple idea, I'm just gonna say a platform to connect with like-minded professionals based on preferences and profile. And it will immediately start drafting the product requirement document. You can go over the requirements here and make sure they all follow what you have envisioned. And then it will also create the flowchart for the whole product. And then after that, you can follow what it's doing here in the sidebar. It's creating all of the necessary code for the whole app. And that's what's really cool about this app. Usually I would go from ideating and structuring with Claude, then to UX Pilot and Figma for the design and manual editing, and then I would get into an AI coding tool. But with this tool here, I can just start from here immediately without ideating with Claude, because it is actually using Claude 3.7, which is the best model so far for coding. You can even turn on the chat only feature here if you want to ideate with Claude before structuring the app. So I love those features. Plus, I will show you how you can design using this tool as well. And there we go. It created the homepage for me. And in this view here in the design tab, you can see the homepage, and I will break it down for you into its components from top to bottom. That's a really cool way to see what components you're using in each page. And the amazing thing here is that when you click on elements, you can edit them in the sidebar. So just like in Figma, you can double click to reach the element that you want, or hit command and click to select a specific element. You can also go to the sidebar here with the DOM tree, and this will be like your layers panel. But yeah, say for example, if I want this to be smaller, be careful when you hit undo, because it will reload the whole project. And I'm very used to clicking undo with Figma and editing software, but here, be careful with the undo. So I can modify the width here, let's say 230. So as you can see, you can manually edit any element by modifying the settings in the side panel in the styles properties. And you have layout options and alignment and styles. This is really good for manual editing. So if you want to interact with the page, you can click the preview mode here, and then you can see how the page interacts. And there we go. We have the send request option already working. Now let's say I want to add navigation with the communities button so that we can add another page here. There we go. It added the communities page. And I'm gonna say, so here's the tricky thing. When you want to add an additional page, it will add it within this page, so you won't see it on your canvas unless you ask specifically to see the other page on the canvas. What I mean is, this is how you add an additional page. So I said add the communities page and add it to the board. So you will be able to navigate to the communities page by clicking on this, but you will also be able to see it on the board. I like to do that because I prefer to see all of my designs on the canvas. There we go, it added a new page to my canvas here that is called the communities page. I'll put it up here. And you can resize it. There we go. But now let's test the website and see how it works. All you have to do is click the play button at the top and it will open in your browser. Now if we click here, it will go to the communities page. And the layout looks beautiful. So I'm gonna say fix the layout in the homepage because this is bothering me a little bit. And there we go, it fixed the layout here a little bit. Looks much better than before. And if you want to edit any component, you can do that by right clicking and selecting edit component. And here you can add variants to that component. What I also like to do is I'll remove all of these components from here because they don't add any value to me. I can just edit my design with AI and just by looking at the main pages that I have. So I don't need all of these components here. I'll just remove them. And I like to see only my main pages on the canvas. And if you want to access your components, you have the assets tab in the sidebar where you can see all of the components that you created. And from here you can reuse them and add them to the canvas. Another really cool thing they have here is the React Components website. This website is for Tempo Labs and they have many components that you can use inside of your project. And it's really cool and it works. Like say for example, I want to use this flipping card effect in my website. I can just copy the code from here. And I'll go back to AI chat here. I'll just say apply this effect to the cards and I'll paste it here. And there we go, it should be applied now. Let's test the website. And here it says click card to flip. And now we have that effect of flipping cards. It's cool that it included extra information on the other side. That's awesome. Check out this website that has free React components that you can use inside of your Tempo Labs project. And when you select an element, you can see that it's structured properly in the side panel here with all of the text properties. And you can modify anything that you want right from within the sidebar here. And it will update the code. It's a really innovative way to control the code visually, just like within any design editor, but you're actually controlling the code. And then of course you can go to the code panel and here you can check out all of your files and your code if you want to do any manual editing for the code. And here I have my GitHub connected and this will allow me to commit changes directly into GitHub. And another feature that I like is if you go back to your main dashboard, here in your project, you can add more features and work on them with your team by using this Kanban board. So like say this is the first feature that we worked on. I can put it in design in progress and then I can add a new feature here and I can say here what this feature is and I will add it to the project. I want to add the login as in separate project. And here you can enter the details of your requirement. I'm just saying I want all of the necessary steps for sign up and login and I can then create the feature and it will add a new project here and it will start generating the pages required for this feature. So as you can see, it pulled in my info here into the project requirements and it pulled in the homepage of the project. And now I can click generate wireframes to generate the necessary steps for this new feature. And there we go, it generated the whole flow for the login process. Let's check it out. Here you can see we have two tabs, sign up and login. And it added more login options and sign up options. That's really cool. So we can work on this and refine it. And once we're good, we can add it to the design review here and add this one to the design review so that we can follow up on these features. And once you're done with the feature, you can commit it to your GitHub repository. All you have to do is add a repository here, and then your project is connected. And then another really important feature is the database. You can connect with Supabase right from within Tempo here. So it says it's still in beta, but it works, and it connects really seamlessly with the database that you have in Supabase. All you have to do is connect, and then it will do everything in the background, and then you can see your project here. So all you have to do now is go to your Supabase account and create a new project, and then you'll find it here. I really see this tool as a sneak peek into the future of building products. It's really exciting to me to see a new AI tool that breaks the traditional workflows and comes up with a new concept that really empowers you as a designer or as a developer. And each member of the team can have more control on how the outcome will look like and control the code. Here's another project that I worked on. I asked it to improve the usability of the process of ordering a meal, and it did that by adding these tabs and this order guide that tells you which page you're on at all times, which is really cool. So all you have to do here is like fill out your preferences for a meal and then click next step, and then you'll see where you are in the order guide here. So if you go to, you can schedule, save schedule, browse meals, it will tell you you are here, and then review your order. It will give you the order details. And yeah, it's still rough around the edges, but it performs really well with just natural language prompts to improve usability, for example, and will understand how to guide the user from step to step. As you can see, the app is really promising and the team is working on implementing new features and improving the usability of the app. And I know they're releasing new features and new improvements very, very soon. So I'll definitely keep an eye out for it, because I honestly believe that this concept and the way it works definitely has the potential to revolutionize the whole industry of building products. Let me know if you have any questions. I'll answer everything down in the comments. Now get back to work.